sahanavavatu sahanavunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shanti. Hariyom Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hariyom Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha, Tasavitur Varenyam, Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi, Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. That's when we do, right? Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva, Tvameva Bandhu Cha Sakha Tvameva, Tvameva Vidya Cha Dharmanam Tvameva, Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva. Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva.
Okay, so we will do, you brought your Bhagavad Gita, right?
Yes.
So, I was thinking today we will read the Swamiji's commentary for the two verses that we are continuing, because the commentary is very good and we don't want to miss what he has to say. So, I think
what
we
the
did
chapter?
Chapter 4. And we did 20, we finished, so we'll do 21 and 22 today.
21, this is
chapter 4 ka?
Nirashi.
Nirashi, yeah. So I'm going to chant, and you guys have, since you have the Gita, you can do it with me if you like.
Yeah.
Nirashi yata chittatma yata sarva parigraha shariram kevalam karma kurvannapto Kurvanna noti kilbisham. Kurvanna noti kilbisham.
There's a P in the
You know, if you can get the Sanskrit, it's an achievement for people like us. Okay, so since you have the book, why don't you read the translation, starting with the translation and the commentary, and then we'll discuss it.
It looks like it starts in the middle, the hopes. Wait, what it is merely body activities. That's, yeah, this is how it started.
Oh, it starts, yeah. Mere bodily activity.
Wait, but that's not the translation. This is the translation.
Oh. Without hope, with the mind and self-control, having abandoned all possessions, doing merely bodily action, he incurs no sin.
So just so that before you go, because it's after 1 week, we kind of forget where we are.
Yeah.
So remember, we were talking about karma yoga, and we were talking about what is our goal. So what kind of action that the sthrita pragna do, and how does he function? So then we can get there. So he's talking about the characteristic of his mind, basically. So that's the background. Theek hai.
Mere bodily activity is not action that will merit a reaction. It has already been seen that the reactions of actions take place in the mental and in the intellectual zone. An action can leave a mark on a subtle body only when we act with an egocentric consciousness that we are the actors, and these marks can be effective only when our actions are motivated by powerful and strong egocentric desires.
So let's this looks a little bit heavy, but we all know what it is, but that he's saying that only bodily activity doesn't mean anything, but it is, you know, what happens
desires,
in the mental zone,
right?
So the person who does not have a egocentric desire, that's the person. Uska wo chipkega nahi. Remember, we were talking about how those
karam.
Impressions
subtle body wo akaram.
So it's saying that an action can leave a mark on a subtle body only when we act with an egocentric consciousness. So
right.
If we can remember that, then we got it made. But that's the whole process, the how to break.
Ego
that.
Hai to tu hai.
Ha. Or ego, exactly.
Ego nahi
aur wo ego kaise nahi hoga? Constant awareness of, now that we have learned what Brahman is, constant awareness of the Brahman breaks the ego. Otherwise, ego can really start coming up very quickly. Subtle way.
Achhi cheezon mein bhi bahut jaldi.
Even very good stuff like, you know, oh, I'm so pious, oh, I'm so sattvic. You know, those kind of ego can come. God knows, it can come hundreds of different ways. So, anyway.
Okay. Ego is created only when the self, in its assumed delusion, identifies itself with the body, mind, and intellect, and their respective fields of objects. This ego draws its sustenance from the hopes of the future and also from the satisfaction of the present possession.
So let's let's analyze this. So it's saying, what is actually ego? Because agar koi bole na ki ego to is so difficult to know, na? What is ego? So now he's defining what ego is. Hopes of the future. You know, but ye hoga to wo hoga. Constant ego cannot live in the present. So that, now that book you're going to be reading, Power of Now, ki type ka book, that's a sequel. So they say, if you live in present, you have no ego. Moment you're thinking of the past and future, that means
that's ego. Right.
So you guys agree, right? So that's what he's talking about.
Therefore, actually, subah uth karke wo kitne prayers hain. Ek wo prayer bahut sundar hai.
Haath wala. Maine bheja tha aapko sare prayers wo aapki.
Wo jo granddaughter ke liye hai. Itna sundar hai.
Karagre vasate Lakshmi. Yes.
Usme hai ki ye Lakshmi
is in my
Sarasvati and the same tino deviyon se ki jo kuch ye haath kare wo wahi se shakti aaye wahi par arpan ho. Sab karam arpan ho gaya hai. So in the morning when you do that and then get up, dharti ko, you know, namaskar karke and then get up. So that you are free for the day.
You know, ek kahawat hai Hindi mein. I don't know if you guys have heard of that kahawat. It says, neki kar aur kuye mein daal.
Darya mein daal. Neki kar, darya mein daal.
So like, whatever you do, because people ko ye bhi bahut ego ho jata hai.
Kua is still stationary, so ego remains there. Yeah. But if you have darya, it has flown away. See,
that darya is even better than kua. I agree with you. Acha, kisi ne na bahut acha ego ka bola. Ki, like ocean ko dekho. So everything is water, right?
Right.
Yeah. Whether it's a wave or foam or anything, it's a something. So he's saying that ego is like a foam. Ki hawa hai usme kuch nahi, upar aake baith jata hai. Because wo jab wave jaati hai na, upar aake.
Halka hai.
Hawa hai, hawa ka you have to pierce it.
So matlab kuch hai nahi dam aur phus karke aise khatam ho jata hai. Lekin sabse aage upar aake.
Like a balloon.
Yes. One second.
Ego will remain till you know that you are separate from the
universe. Ego just merges.
It cannot go away.
Yeah, if you feel you are one of nature.
Yeah.
So like Ramakrishna said, he has very little ego, but still it is there.
And as long as you have body, it will be there.
Yeah.
That's true.
So there is.
You can function only from
but
ego.
But when he goes in meditation mode, then it's not there.
Yes.
So that's
What even Chinmayananji always says that when they're talking about this merging, that is, when they come back to the world, they have to use their intellect. They have to, but they know it is a tool.
Yeah, they are detached.
Hum log ko nahi padta.
Yeah, they are detached.
And they're able to use it as a tool and withdraw it.
Because, you know, today only I heard, I should discuss this with you, it's very beautiful, that I was listening to one of our acharyas, I mean, he's the head of Chinmaya Mission previously. First was Chinmayananji, then Tejomayananji. Tejomayananji. And now third one has come. So Tejomayananji's lecture. He's also very good. So he was saying ki isme ek word hai ki bhai you have to have a sama buddhi. So he said whether it is a gold or a clay or ek mitti padi ho, gold ho, or one more thing he said. They are all same. So he's saying, don't think that he's saying that you should not know the value of it.
Right.
But you should have the correct value of it.
Right.
Don't overdue value.
Right.
You know? That was number one. And he's saying that whatever you need, like if you need a brick to build a house, you cannot build a house with the gold.
Right.
You know? Or if you want an ornament, you cannot do it with the bricks. So that kind of understanding, that's called samabuddhi. Ye nahi ki bhai, wo gold pada to usko bhi fek do. Because, you know, so there is definition has has to have some intelligence behind it. You cannot just take it literal, because the moment you take it literal, it's a disaster. You know. But then some people who gold ke piche itna wo crazy ho jata hai ki nothing matters to them. Na family, na friends, na kuch. You know, means the correct value of it in your life you should know. That's it. That's what called samabuddhi. I thought that was a very great point that he brought.
Therefore, the stanza declares that an individual, when he has completely renounced hope, when he has brought his body and mind under perfect control, and when he has relinquished all possessions.
Sense of possession. That's the most important. Yahan par sense likha hua.
Yahan par nahi hai.
Achha.
Relinquished all possessions can no longer sustain the illusory concept of the ego in him. When the ego has ended, the actions performed by that individual's body become incapable of leaving any permanent mark upon the mental constitution or on his intellectual character.
Right.
He's repeating.
In
sleep, if I become naked, I'm not charged of any indecent behavior. My God. Thank God for that. If in my sleep, my body kicks my own son, I am not accused of cruelty to my child. For in both the above cases, we know that for the actions of my body, I am not responsible, since I was absent in that body during those activities. This clearly shows that the egocentric identity with the body is the actor and the sufferer. And where the ego is not, there the mere bodily actions cannot bring about any consequences.
Okay, I think we understood. Yeah.
A self-realized saint's activities do not touch him at all, since he is not the actor. The actions only flow through him. Such a truly great one becomes not a doer of actions, but serves as a glorious instrument for the Lord's will to express itself.
So that's the main thing, that they function but as a Lord's will.
If the music coming from a violin is not good, the audience does not attack the violin, although the violins cannot be very safe. Throw tomatoes. The violin of its own accord does not make music, but it allows music to emanate from it at the touch of the flying bow and the tickling fingers of the performer. Its duties end when its supple chords have bent under the touch of the musician's dancing fingers. An egoless man of perfection is the wonder instrument through which the divine orchestra plays, singing the song of the Lord's own will, faithfully. Any activity undertaken by a perfect master does not and cannot bring about any consequences, good or evil, upon him. He is only a divine instrument. Okay. Though a self-realized man renounces all actions, he has of necessity to barely maintain his body. Such a man, steady on the path of knowledge, is ever liberated to teach this, the Lord says.
Okay. So, we all know about this instrument part, right?
Yeah.
We have discussed it before, that how you become an instrument. So, I think our job is to make our mind so pure that we do become instruments of God.
Right.
Right? That should be our goal. So that we'll do one more verse. Yadruchalambha santushtaha dvandvatito vimatsaraha samasiddhava siddhyocha krutvapi na nibadhyate. Should I read it if you got tired?
No, I can read it. Content with what comes to him without effort, free from the pairs of opposites and envy, even-minded in success and failure. Though acting, he is not bound.
So he's going further into how does he behave? That free from pair of opposite and envy, he doesn't have any envy, even-minded in success and failure. Hum log ko kaise, oh my God, we get so disturbed.
Upset and
Agar failure aaya to dam depressed ho gaye, aur success aaya to kudne
mein. Khush ho gaye, yeah.
Guys are different when they dance to a different tune.
Such an individual who has gone beyond his own ego can thereafter commence no desire prompted activity with any definite fruit motive. Naturally, he will feel quite contented and happy in whatever gain spontaneously rises out of its actions. The state of egolessness indicates a condition of perfect conquest over the mind and intellect. Naturally, therefore, the pairs of opposites, heat and cold, success and failure, good and bad, joy and sorrow, etc., cannot affect him, they being always interpretations of the world of objects by the mind. Where the mind has ended, the intellect too can no more bring its own affections and prejudices, or a spirit of competitions and jealousies. We generally get agitated due to the pulls of success and failure. On the rising tide of success, our ego dances in a vain joy, while in the hollows of failures, it feels miserable and crushed. But when the ego is completely divinized, the individual will thereafter automatically remain equanimous in both success and failure. Such an individual who has thus conquered his egocentric misconceptions about himself, though acting, is not fettered by the natural consequences of the actions performed.
Karma phala.
When such a perfect master of realization lives amidst us, he is generally seen to act in no way different from an ordinary sensible man, and yet all the same his activities shows an extra dynamic capacity to carve out a more complete and enduring success. According to the last verse, the activities of a man of knowledge do not in any sense of the term affect him. Naturally, it becomes a little difficult for an ordinary man to know readily how this is accomplished by the sage. To explain the divine motive and attitude with which men of perfection act in the world, the following 9 stanzas are declared by the Lord. So, what are the stanzas? Continue?
No. I think too, because we have to go back to the Upanishad. Yeah. But I think these are, to me, it's very important because very practical. Otherwise, you know, Upanishad is good to know, but where how we can apply, that's where Gita comes in so nicely. Because, you know, like he said, the karma phala is the one that he doesn't get affected by. And I think there is one word that they use in Bhagavad Gita. It's called prasada buddhi. I don't know if you've heard of that word. Prasad buddhi means, just how we go in the mandir, and then many prasada, what do we do? We don't say, oh, usko laddu kyun diya, mujhe ye kyun diya, कोई क्रश्ड बनाना भी होएगा तो हम ऐसे लेके और भी यू नो
वी एक्सेप्ट व्हाटएवर वी गेट
एक्जेक्टली दैट्स प्रसाद बुद्धि सो हम लोग के पास व्हेन वी हैव आवर ईगो वर्किंग वी डोंट हैव द प्रसाद बुद्धि
राइट
वी आर ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू से ये क्यों वो क्यों ऐसा मेरे साथ क्यों हुआ
ऐसा क्यों हुआ
या एंड आई थिंक दैट फेमस स्टोरी इज देयर नो दिस वन फेलो हु वाज अ ओलंपिक चैंपियन एंड ही गॉट सम वेरी बैड डिजीज कैंसर पता नहीं क्या हुआ उसको तो किसी ने उसको इंटरव्यू में पूछा कि you know, how you deal with this. So he said that it is God's will or something like that. And he said, when I got the Olympic, that time I didn't ask why me. Mm-hmm. Why should I ask now? You know? Oh, it was such amazing that he's saying that. So that's what happens that when
the good you accept, the bad you say, good, this
is what happens with good. Good we think, many kia.
Yeah.
Good mana, maine kiya. But if you really look at your life, you get so many things that you feel like you don't even deserve and you're getting.
Yeah.
Right? Sometimes it happens, there's an overload of things that happen.
You really feel all the time, you know, in gratitude.
and then other times when things are not going well, so but it's a whole together, it's a package deal, right? You get some good things, some bad. Everybody
because,
has that.
Because
when you forget yourself,
for you can't have only good. Then you want to appreciate.
Exactly. That's what someone else said too. He said that agar, that's why this world is created because you have that churning going between opposites. Khatam hi tha. Tab tumko lagta hai you wake up from that.
Yeah.
Agar sab kuch acha, arey kisi ko dekho. In fact, one of the things that I've heard, which makes a lot of sense. कि भाई अमेरिका में लाइक ऑल दीज डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज हैव मोर डिप्रेशन मोर एंजाइटी बिकॉज दे हैव टू मच वो वहां पर वो दूसरी कंट्री में उनको 2 रोटी मिल जाए तो उसमें इतने खुश है वो दे हैप्पी दे आर डांसिंग और यहां पर
ओवर
सब कुछ दे दो
ओवर देयर यू नो इन द व्हेन आई केम एट डाउनटाउन देयर आर सो मेनी होमलेस
राइट
सो आई शुड टेल अश्विनी दैट आई फील वेरी वेरी You know, looking at them, mere ko kuch hota hai.
Right.
So Ashwin says, you come from a country full of beggars. So wahan kuch nahi hota hai. I said, वहाँ कुछ नहीं होता है क्योंकि they are dancing. तुम they will come to your car. तुम दोगे दोगे नहीं दोगे ठेंगा दिखा के चले जाएंगे मुंह चढ़ा के चले जाएंगे. And you know there are so many opportunities where you can go out and just do something. You know.
Yeah.
यहाँ पर हम थोड़ा ना अगर फोर फीडिंग करेंगे बैठ करके बैलगुआ पार्क में.